is an unoccupied autonomous sailing craft controlled remotely by Saildrone Incorporated using an app on the iPhone and houses a suite of sensors and instruments for collecting data from the environment.
The Saildrone is around 20 feet long, 18 feet off the water, weighs about 600 pounds, and can operate kind of indefinitely. You know, the wind is propulsion that pushes it along, a solar charge of the batteries, which runs the computers and the communications.
NOAA's Pacific Marine Environmental Laboratory began using Saildrones in 2015 to study physical oceanography. Two Saildrones sailed the Bering Sea off the coast of Alaska for 97 days, traveling 4,500 miles, taking measurements of wind, sea temperature, and salinity, all important factors affecting food availability for fish and marine mammals. These measurements are typically taken by scientists aboard large research vessels. Ships can cost tens of thousands of dollars a day to operate and can go into depths of about 20 meters. On the other hand, Saildrones can travel into shoreline areas to depths of 3 meters and continue sampling in shallow water. While shipwork is weather dependent, Saildrones can stay out for 6 to 12 months at a time and continue sampling in extreme conditions. In addition to sampling ocean processes, scientists are using Saildrones to gather data on valuable fish species, such as pollock. In the Saildrone's 250-pound payload is an echosounder, an instrument which bounces sound waves off the backs of fish, allowing the Saildrone to record the abundance of fish in a given area. NOAA's Alaska Fisheries Science Center first used Saildrone technology in 2016 to collect data on pollock.
The Saildrone work is going to be done during the time that we're doing an acoustic trawl survey of walleye pollock, and we conduct semi-annual surveys to measure the number of fish present in the area, and that's used directly to set fishing quotas. The pollock fishery is a large industrial fishery in Alaska. There's a lot of effort in management of the fishery, and so I think that this has an important impact on it.
The pollock fishery contributes 1/3 of the total U.S. commercial catch. It's also the primary food source of a local declining population of northern fur seals. Saildrones were also used in 2016 to track seal foraging habits. They can be programmed to follow an individual animal. Knowing fur seal locations and dive information helps scientists understand food availability for this population.
Specifically, we want to know how fur seals adapt their behavior in response to fish availability and fish location, and how these changes relate to overall foraging success, which is ultimately related to their reproductive success and their survival.
In addition to the pollock and fur seal work, scientists also tested the use of Saildrones with other acoustic technology to learn about endangered species, like the North Pacific right whale. To do this, a Saildrone was equipped with an acousonde, an underwater recorder which listens to detect the presence of whales.
The most important question we're hoping to have answered is, where are the right whales going, or where are they coming into the Bering Sea from? By exploring those areas that we haven't been able to survey in over a decade, if we are able to detect North Pacific right whales, that would extend our knowledge on their distribution and fill in some of those information gaps that are needed for conservation efforts.
Saildrone technology opens up a whole new world of monitoring, recording, and collecting research information. The data gathered may be used for making informed management decisions about valuable commercial fisheries that affect our economy and food supply. In addition to gaining knowledge about species such as protected seals and whales.